everyone. A very logical morning to you all. Welcome to our series, Vidigya Presents Quizdom Series, in which we are going to ask you 10 questions of vocabulary along with 10 questions of GK and current affairs. Yes, you heard me right. Today we are following the newspaper dated 21st January 2024. What? You have missed the earlier quizzes? Well, that's some bad news. Time to subscribe our YouTube channel quickly and follow all the quizzes for the month of January. Yes, you heard me right. Everyday practice, everyday dose of 10 questions for vocabulary and GK. Let's get started for today's quiz. Gear up everyone, ready, and I'm going to drop first question for vocabulary. Vidigya Vocab Vista, question number one. Here we go. The bride's face radiated with sheer dash as she walked down the aisle on her wedding day. Is it A, desolation? Is it B, melancholy? Is it C, felicity? Or is it D, dreariness? See, sometimes in questions like these, it is simple to spot the answer. Reason being, three options are very like near synonyms of each other. In this case, if when we talk about desolation, we talk about melancholy and we talk about dreariness. The bride's face radiated with cheer. We are obviously looking for a term which shows the bride's face radiated with happiness, right? So desolation is misery, sorrow. Melancholy is again sadness. Then we have dreariness, which is again sadness. So we have an option, felicity here, which indicates intense happiness. All right, answer is C, felicity. Let's move to question number two, everyone. The scientist was pressured to dash his groundbreaking theory, but he steadfastly stood by his research. Your options are A, affirm, B, reiterate, C, recant, or is it D, validate? The correct answer here is C, recant. The scientist was pressured to, agar affirm hota, that means affirming that yes, whatever he has said, that is correct. Reiterate would be just to repeat and say it again, once again. Validate means to give it validation. Yes, again affirming, whatever he has given or stated is correct. But the context here says, the scientist was pressured to dash his groundbreaking theory. We need an option which goes opposite to this context. Like the scientist was pressured to withdraw his groundbreaking theory. Like whatever he has said, they wanted it. Like he should withdraw from all his views, opinions stated regarding his theory. So that means like they wanted him to publicly not affirm. So affirm, reiterate or validate, all three are incorrect. Recant, which shows that they wanted him to publicly disavow, publicly not affirm to whatever his theory states. So answer is C, recant. Let's come to question number three, everyone. The family reunion was characterized by an atmosphere of warmth and dash with relatives sharing stories and laughter. Your options are A, animosity, B, hostility, C, aloofness, or is it D, bonhomie? Bonhomie is the correct answer here. Reason being, bonhomie indicates C, family reunion, atmosphere of warmth, and bonhomie with relatives. Bonhomie shows the warmth and love of the family here, whereas other options, animosity, hostility, aloofness, they all show hatred. So that is totally against the context. Answer is D, bonhomie. Question number four. After realizing the consequences of his actions, he expressed sincere dash and sought forgiveness from those he had wronged. Your options are A, defiance, B, penitence, C, impenitence, or is it D, unrepentance? Let's come to the context quickly. After realizing the consequences of his actions, he expressed sincere dash and sought forgiveness. So we need a term which shows that he was repenting and he sought forgiveness. Coming to option A, defiance. Defiance is incorrect because that would be going against whatever he's saying and not at all feeling sorry or asking for forgiveness. Then we have unrepentance, not feeling repentance. This is again incorrect. Coming to penitence. Penitence means a deep feeling of regret or sorrow, feeling sorry. So impenitence is clearly opposite. Correct answer is B, penitence. Number five. Unable to afford lunch, he decided to dash a meal from his generous friend. Is it A, purchase? Is it B, procure? Is it C, attain? Or is it D, catch? Purchase, procure and attain. He was unable to afford lunch. That means he was short of money. So procuring, acclaiming or attaining is something that is not possible here. Catch. Catch means that under circumstances, you are so miserable and not able to afford something in this case that you literally beg someone for something. So catch is correct here. Being very persistent in asking something. Number 6. The children grew increasingly dash as they eagerly awaited the announcement of the summer vacation plans. Is it A, feisty? Is it B, relaxed? Is it C, serene? Or is it D and C? The children grew increasingly dash as they eagerly awaited the announcement of the summer vacation. So this clearly shows that the children became increasingly restless, right? So option says A, feisty. Feisty means energetic, very lively. So feisty is incorrect here. Relaxed and serene, to be calm. No, against the context. B and C is absolutely correct here, because and C shows the restlessness of the children here. Coming to number 7. Number 7 is the politician chose not to respond to the personal attacks and dash from the opposing party, maintaining a focus on policy issues. Your options are A, acclaim, B, revile, C, commend, or is it D, applaud? Coming to the question real quick, the politicians chose not to respond to the personal attacks. This can be rude. So acclaiming or commending or applauding, all three are incorrect based on this context. Only option, which is option B, revel, which means criticizing, is correct. Okay, let's jump to question number 8, everyone. Over time, the constant flow of water had a gradual and persistent effect. Slowly dash the once sturdy rocks along the riverbank. Your options are A, fortifying, B, stabilizing, C, strengthening, or is it D, eroding? All the three. Over time, the constant flow of water had a gradual, persistent effect. Slowly dash the rocks which were once really sturdy, very hard. Over time, due to flowing water, constant flow of water might have become weak, and what we say here is eroded, gone bad. Fortifying would be stabilizing something, making something more stronger. Stabilizing and strengthening are also alike. Correct answer is D, eroding. Okay, question number 9, everyone. Just two more to go. Question number 9. Despite reassurances, her irrational fears and constant suspicion of others revealed a deeply ingrained sense of dash. Your options are A, hesitant, B, paranoia, C, confidence, or is it D, assurance? Coming to the context, despite reassuring someone again and again that everything is fine, nothing is wrong, suspicion of others, irrational fears which are not actually there, but you feel something is going wrong, then you have a suspicion on others, you keep doubting others. So that makes a person go paranoid. So hesitant is incorrect here. Confidence and assurance are also positive context word here. They're incorrect. Paranoia means it's a condition, it's a medical condition. But other than that, it is used in context wise simple as a term for being crazy or being out of your mind. So that is paranoia. Okay, let's move to the last question of Vidigya Vocab Vista, everyone. Question number 10. The scandal threatened to dash the reputation of the esteemed company, causing concern among stakeholders. So the scandal would definitely destroy the image of a company, defame it. So the correct answer here would be options outlandish, B, polish, C, burnish, or is it D, tarnish? Tarnish is the correct answer here, because tarnish means, like we did this term, eroding. Erode means gone bad. So same goes with tarnish. Tarnishing is defaming here someone's image, going bad. Option A, outlandish, is incorrect, because that simply means from, like, very strange, not belonging here, or particularly behaving in a very strange manner. That's outlandish. Polish is, of course, we know, to make something fine, lustrous, better. That's polish. Option C, burnish also means to polish or make something more lustrous. So correct answer is option D, tarnish, gone bad. Okay, this brings us to the end of Vidigya Vocab Vista. It's time for the GK Quest. Get ready for Vidigya GK Quest, everyone, dated 21 January 2024. The first question drops right here. Number one, Union Home Minister announced to fence the entire length of currently porous India. Dash border, you have to tell me, India dash border. Is it A, Myanmar? Is it B, Pakistan? Is it C, Bangladesh? Or is it D, Nepal? So the correct answer here is, let's check everyone. It's A, everyone, India-Myanmar border. That's the correct answer. Let's move to question number two. Which Indian state shares international border with Myanmar? Your options are A, Tripura, B, Assam, C, Mizoram, or is it D, Manipur? The correct answer is four northeastern states with Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur, and Mizoram. They share international boundary with Myanmar. So the correct answer is C, Mizoram. All right, question number three, everyone. Central Consumer Protection Authority, CCPA, was established under the Consumer Protection Act of, is it A, 2012, is it B, 2015, is it C, 2019, or is it D, 2020? Let's check the correct answer. The correct answer is C, 2019, everyone. Consumer Protection Act of 2019. Wonderful, guys. Let's move to question number four. What is the height of Ram Lala idol which is placed in the Garbhagriha in Ayodhya? Your options are A, 11 inch, B, 21 inch, C, 51 inches, or is it D, 101 inch? Let's check the correct answer. The correct answer is 51 inches. All right, let's move to question number five. Already on question number five, everyone, I hope you are getting your answers correct. Number 5, Indian doubles badminton player Chirag Shetty and S. Ranki Reddy lost to SJCO and MH Kang of which country in finals of India Open 2024? Your options are A, China, B, Japan, C, Indonesia, or is it D, South Korea? Let's check the correct answer, everyone. Answer is option D, South Korea. Well done, guys. Time for question number 6. Which player has won the men's singles title at India Open 2024? Your options are Shi Yuqi, option B, Lee Chak Yu, option S, C, H.S. Pranoy, or is it D, Priyanshu Rajawat? Let's check the correct answer, everyone. Correct answer is A, Shi Yuqi. Well done, everyone. Okay, time for question number 7. Number 7 is India to send an industry delegation to which country to discuss potential copper exploration and mining? Your options are A, Peru, B, Zambia, C, Zimbabwe, or is it D, Chile? Answer is, let's check everyone, it's B, Zambia. Very good, everyone. Those who got the answers correct. Chalo. Just three more to go and number 8 is already here. Competition Commission of India, CCI, is a statutory and quasi-judicial body working under. Your options are A, Ministry of Finance, Ministry of Corporate Affairs, is it C, Ministry of Consumer Affairs, or is it D, Ministry of Coal? The correct answer goes right here, everyone. Ministry of Corporate Affairs. The Competition Commission of India, CCI, is a statutory and quasi-judicial body working under Ministry of Corporate Affairs. Just two more to go. Question number 9 on your screen, everyone. Which country's startup BetaVolt has developed a nuclear battery that can produce power for 50 years without charge? Your options are A, USA, B, China, C, Russia, or is it D, Germany? Let's see what is the correct answer, everyone. Answer is B, China. Okay, time for one last question for this GK quest. Right here, INSAT, or the Indian National Satellite System of ISRO, is placed in which orbit? Your options are A, low Earth orbit, is it B, geostationary orbit, is it C, sun synchronous orbit, or is it D, polar orbit? Answer goes right here, B, INSAT or the Indian National Satellite System is a series of multi-purpose geostationary satellites launched by ISRO. So answer is B, geostationary, everyone. Wonderful. This brings us to the end of today's quiz. Thank you so much for participating. See you all tomorrow for 22nd January quiz dump. So please be ready and come. Till then, stay logical.